Rain God has alarmed us that it's time, it has started to now go down and start our lecture also. Right? Good afternoon. We would like to welcome you at the last lecture, which most of the time is going to be pretty dangerous for the simple reason because it's last, and we in a very rhetorical language call it the final nail on the coffin. Right? The last aspect we both of the faculties were having a brainstorming, what should we talk about? And then we decided that it's better that we end up our lecture about something which is so prevalent and banally present around us that it affects the way we understand language, we speak language. Then I hope that these days most of you are aware of this, that if you want to go abroad, all of you will have to clear some exams. If you want to apply for some scholarships abroad, you have to clear exams like IELTS and GRE and GMAT and TOEFL and so on and so forth. Right? So this is a very propitious time, a good time to talk to you about social linguistics and applied languages. As the name tells you, and it's a kind of self-explanatory, when we talk about social linguistics, it's going to talk about the social aspect related to linguistics. When I say social aspect related to linguistics, I think everything at the end of the day, when it's a language, there is going to be an inevitable correlation between society and language. A. B. And now social linguistics is different, right, from society and language. And C. And according to me, the most important thing, you have learned now some of the aspects of linguistics, like what? You can identify the sounds now. If we give you certain sounds, I assume that you can put those sounds together and you can make few words. If we give you words, lengthy words, you can break the words, decode it, can understand that there is a root word, there is a prefix, there is a suffix, so you are good at morphology. Right? And then we will talk about how sentences make their sense. You are also aware that yes, sentences make their sense besides even learning of grammar, which we did in our previous class. Right? And what you did in the previous class with Jasmeet sir was the aspect of pragmatics. Again, somewhere or other is related to the meaning of the paragraphs and sentences and the text and the discourse. Right? As I told you today, when you talk about linguistics, as a student of linguistics, you have to understand that you are not only going to analyze the text, you are also going to analyze a movie, a setting of a classroom, a painting, and let it be almost anything under the sun can be analyzed linguistically. Do we need a specific vocabulary for that? Yes. Right? And most importantly, I was very curious to this lecture because this lecture is very personal to me because it immediately makes me aware about the problems I face in a classroom. Let's assume in a statistic and idealistic situation that I have a classroom almost of this strength. Now, this should not even be strength of a class. Right? Even UGC has laid down certain rules that a class should be ideally somewhere between 30 to 40 students, so we can leave personal attention to each of the students. Right? So first problem in Indian university is that the places where we have big classes like 100, 200, in my previous universities, one of my journal English class, which was meant for 8 colleges in that university, I had highest number of students, 976 students in one class. And I had a very hard time. University would not let me get the Xerox for the students. Right? Because if I go for one exercise, it will cost them 10,000 to 20,000 rupees. Two-sided, one Xerox. There are specific problems. The second problem comes is, what do we do in a classroom when some students expect me to speak slow, speak low, and use an English which they can understand with a mix of Hindi and English? And the other students are very smart. They don't find that lecture interesting because for them it is below average. They want some extraordinary words, vocabulary, and they want some extra help. How do we bring such diversity, such disparity, such beauty, I would call it, among the students at one level in a classroom? Let's have a look at this. Look at that, you have a picture here. Try to make some sense out of this picture. This is a picture. In the first picture, you have these three students, right? And they are standing here to watch a football game. Let's say the aim, the objective of the classroom is same, that all of you are here to learn something. But then One is a very top student and they all are given equal opportunities. As we give you equal lecture at a time in the classroom. Now this is a tall guy, he is almost above the board. This is a girl which is almost afford to watch it. And this is the third guy who cannot. Right? This is equality. We have provided them all with equal opportunity. But does it look like a good classroom setting? No. Right? So in Indian classroom especially, or classrooms in India or any other country where English is not their mother tongue, I'm going to introduce you to the term L2, which is known as learning language or acquired language second. So English is our L2, right? Our L1 is mostly going to be our mother tongues, right? So look at this now. What we as teachers and what you students as students have to do is, this guy is already up to that extent where somebody has to be above average in a classroom. He will not need any extra help from anyone of us. Right? She is absolutely making sense, almost identical to third one. But this third student, right? More than equal opportunity, I will have to bring him above with the second extra help so that he is also capable to get the goal. The goal of a teacher in a classroom, or a goal of students when you come, objective, why all of you have come here? So that you learn something. There can be a lot of classes which disappoint you. You go to a classroom with a lot of expectations from teacher, and we suffer with a lot of problems like this, right? Every day cannot be a great day. Tendulkar cannot hit a turn every time, right? So every day when we also come to perform in a classroom, it cannot be almost a perfect day for all of us. You will also tomorrow be in our shoes, I hope. And you have been a teacher in one capacity or another for your younger brother and sister, your nephew, nieces, for your roommate, students around you. We always talk, we communicate, and we teach that we are in that. The scenario which is presented here, and we have named it equity, right, is the main concern of social justice. I, as a teacher, have always been very, very concerned about this idea. How do we bring all of our students almost first at the equal platform? So this is my beginning, and then little bit better for those who need some extra help. If I have failed to do this, right, then we all have failed as a community of learners, as teachers, and better we call it one. Right? Now how do we cope? What kind of problems are going to come into way? And how do we cope with this? Is the objective of today's class. So we are going to deal it with a dual genre space kind of problem. One side is going to talk about social linguistics, which according to me is a very, very important aspect of learning English. And second is going to be applied linguistics. Squeeze yourself in so three of you can sit together. So if you don't have a space, please squeeze in. Let the third person come and sit beside you. See what we are talking about. Equity. Whatever our resources, let's do the best. Hurry up, get in. Okay. I will again come back to this picture, and after the lecture, we will try to get your feedback also. Right? As a community of students, what expectations you have from all of us as your teachers. Right? When we talk about something like sociolinguistics and all, I think there are going to be some basic definitions and ideas associated with that. So let's have a quick basic definition. Linguistics. You know what is the definition of linguistics today? Sociolinguistics, right? The study of language in relation to society. What do I mean by that? How do I study the language in relation to society? For instance, culture. For instance, ethnicity. For instance, being a boy who was born in Rajasthan is today teaching in Varanasi, and ironically to a group of students for whom English can be a big problem. Right? So for me, my concern should not be teaching you English. For me, my first concern should be that as part of society, and as part of society on my own behalf, what are obvious problems, extra problems, rather than the problems of English, grammar and all, that's secondary. that does not come into the picture as a primary force for me. So when I'm delivering my lecture or I'm preparing something, I have to keep it in my mind that this is meant for the students of higher Tibetan studies. The students for whom English can produce a little bit nightmarish kind of expressions in their mind. Right? So social linguistics A will make you aware as a learner about your identity. What is your background? Where do you come from? What kind of society you are part of? And basically, what kind of society you wish to be part of? Are you the kind of students who don't want to improve, which I don't buy the thought, because that's why I think you want to improve, that's why out of, let's say, 1,000 students, almost 100 students are present in this class, because we want to bring a change. Now, how do we bring that change? What is the bigger field of social linguistics, right? There are language varieties, there are dialectics, there are problems, and especially, even the way, if you are a sponge and you are going to absorb, everybody is not going to absorb the equal amount of water, right? Agar aap sab log chai ki cup hai, let's assume that image, right? Everybody is not of same size. So when I'm going to pour the tea, I will have to be very careful ki kisko kitni chai deni hai, kisko kitni chai deni hai, kisko, otherwise it will start to overbrim and fall off. Social linguistics also talks about this kind of problem. What are the areas which we suffer with when we talk about social linguistics? Look at that. There are slangs which are used. You will not find them in classes. You will not find them in vocabulary, even dictionary. Jargons, you will not find. Idioms, you will have to learn. Right? जैसे बनारस में और कोई लोग मजाक में कहावत बोलते हैं और हमें वो कहावत आती नहीं है. इसका मतलब am I not well learned? No, I am well learned. It's just that I have to learn the lingo and the idiom which is specifically used in Banaras, specifically used in Bhopal, specifically used in South India. Right? There are dialects, vernacular languages, foreign languages, second language, native language, standard. Now, look at the connection between these two. Native languages and second languages. Your native language is Tibetan. Let's say my native language is Hindi. What do I do? When I speak English, some of you still go through this problem that when you are trying to speak in English, you first transliterate the thought in your mother tongue and then try to check for a while if it falls under proper grammar and then try to speak. Sometimes because your options from, you remember vertical axis I talked to? From vertical axis is not coming properly, you have hesitation. And that causes impurity complex in you. That's why most of you don't come at forward and talk in English. That's a big complicated psychological linguistic arena which works in our head. Right? The moment you enter into a, let's say, interview room or we call you on Saturdays for the presentations, your whole body language is capable to tell us that you are going to burst it or you are going to bang it. Right? That means there are few more things besides language, linguistics, learning grammar, vocabulary. There are few things. Can we first understand them? Can we then after understanding, try to understand how to recover from that damage? And after recovering that damage, can we try to recover up to the level where we are capable to speak really well? I'm not saying speak fluently. Speak so that other people can A, to start with, understand you clearly, and then you can get mastery over this. Right? Let's talk. There are few slides, as I told you, these slides I'm going to give you. Everything is not meant for discussion. There are few slides I have just meant for all of you so that you will read and understand. Right? It's not going to make a difference if you understand definition. If you not know, tell me the name of 10 linguists who gave the concept of social linguistics. Nothing is going to happen. Don't worry. So don't bother about knowing about Chomsky or this or that. But if you don't understand the process, then it's a problem. So I'm not concerned about definition, origins, idea. That is there because it has to be part of a good lecture where you can do this reading afterwards also. Right? There are a few things I'm going a little bit faster. Let's first understand the definition. Social linguistics is the study of the effect of any and all aspects of society on languages. Right? First, talk about the language which is spoken in the same society. So let's talk about this. Has Tibetan as a language grown over the years? Or do you think that the language which was spoken in 1850s, 1840s, 1700 is exactly the same today? What I'm asking is a big question. Do languages get affected by society, societal changes? Of course, vocabulary does. आज लैपटॉप आया 1990 के बाद, तो मुझे एक वर्ड बनाना पड़ा ना लैपटॉप में, तो तिब्बतियन लैंग्वेज में लैपटॉप को क्या कहते हैं? क्या वो 1700 की डिक्शनरी में मिलेगा आपको वर्ड? नहीं मिलेगा। फायरवॉल, क्रैश, बग्स, एप्स, राइट, स्मार्टफोन। अर्लियर यू माइट हैव हर्ड अबाउट स्मार्ट पीपल, बट नाउ मोर देन पीपल, फोन्स आर सपोज्ड टू बी स्मार्ट, right? So vocabularies have to change. When vocabularies change, accordingly language also has to change. You talk in a different way now, right? The way your teachers used to teach, some of you are from monastery, right? They are those classical traditional teachers who still speak in a kind of language which is a book bound language, which is governed by certain laws. But we tend to speak in a language which is more flexible, right? If there are even errors, not a problem, and it is a mixing of lot of ideas together. So sometimes you speak an English word, a Hindi word, and that way most of the time it's the tone of and impact of your vernacular language. Do you agree with me? So of course society from which you come from has a direct, deep, essential and very effective impact on the language we speak. The selection of the words I choose to do tells you from what kind of educational background I have got. Right? It also studies how language varieties differ between groups separated by certain social variables, that is ethnicity, religion, status, gender, level of education, age, etc. Does an old man speak the same way a young boy's vocabulary will be there?
No.
Right? Tibet, such an amazing geographical land where I came to know today that it's divided into three geographical lands, right? People, the way they will speak in one part, of course, must be varying from another part, right? What? Even geography, even the places you come from, right? I was trying to understand Tibetan linguistics a bit better and I realized that most of the Tibetan language is directly in relation with the high temperatures. I should say low temperature, right? Low temperature, that means when it goes in minus, you use a lot of cool words. Now look at the irony. When I say they use a lot of cool words, now the way we understand the word cool is totally different. We say he's a cool guy, right? But Tibetan language and linguistics has evolved from a lot of cool words. The food items, right? The clothes. I realized that when students were talking about the clothes, they always talk about a doublet or a cloth which has to come on a shirt or something else. We don't have that cloth in our country because the area I come from, temperature is almost above 50. We never have a coat, right? But certain countries have, because geography, culture, practices, food, ethnicity, age, religion, everything is going to have a direct impact on the rise of a language, dissemination of a language, evolution of a language. Right? As the uses of languages varies from place to place, languages uses also varies among social classes. Right? I often used to go in Jaipur Literary Festival. Being an English teacher also, I used to get scared there. Because everybody talks there in a fake kind of English. You know, the so-called sophisticated English which sounds absolutely fake. Right? Now, high class, low class. Right? Vernacular languages, standard English. Babu English, King's English, Queen's English. These are all words. Let's not bother about that. English, according to me, today should not be written with capital E. Let's deprive the world of its colonial entity and let's put it with a small e and always put plural in the end. Never call it English. Call it Englishes. Right? So that there is Indian English now, there is African English, there is Australian English, there is Canadian English, and every English is different. I today do not have any pressure on me to talk in British tone to any one of you. If I do, I'll be faking myself. So don't do that. Right? Social linguists often shows us the humorous reality. If you will move around in India as an English teacher, whenever I move in any space in India, my eyes immediately catch the fun. I will not call it mistakes. The fun of certain hoardings, certain advertisement and certain things. So if you are not aware of social linguistics, and I realize Hyderabad mein jaoge, so when I used to go there at airport and in the buses and all, they have the habit of putting ra after everything, which surprisingly students also do it here. When they are making presentation, right? And I don't call it something wrong. I'm just observing it. So they'll say, so Shakespeare Ra, Milton Ra, right? And I do understand from that Ra is coming because it's so deeply associated in your spoken Tibetan language that you do speak it sometime. I hope you can understand what I'm saying. Right? So let's have the look of some of the funny advertisements, right? And try to capture. I will be very happy if even some of you can tell me from which area this coding was taken up, but that will be a deep sociological study. Let's have a look at that. Look at that. No parking. If you park here, your tire will be air out. That's total transliteration from the isme aapko pata chalega because it's written in Tamilian language also. So it's from South India. They just transliterated ki bhai hawa nikal di jayegi. So unhone kya likh diya? The tire will be air out. There is no such expression in English. Right? Sarkari thandi beer ki dukaan. Not beer, right? It's beer ki dukaan. Child bear. What they should have written here? They should have written chilled beer. B-E-E-R. Chilled. But instead of that, what they have written? Child bear. And when I looked at this, I knew that it's from Punjab. And I know the reason also. Right? Anyway. Sonu Cafe Tibetan. Now look at that. Pretty interesting outlook. Right? And look at that. Now look at the, please be very careful about the use of Hindi also, English also, and how you translate English word in Hindi and vice versa. Alu paratha, cheese paratha, honey Tibetan bread, look at the spelling. Pancake, look at that. You eat it, it will give you immense pain. Jam pancake. Right? Now look at Hindi. Sabji, dal, chawal, chapati. And look at the spelling of chaumin. It should be M-I-M-E-I-N, right? And the things. Look at this. Especially this. You know that this is not the correct spelling of Tibetan. Right? But the way we speak in India is, look at the stress. Tibetan. कैसे बोलते हैं तिब्बतियन ये लीजिए फिर तिब्बतियन द वे आई विल स्पीक दिस इज फ्रॉम राजस्थान बाय द वे यू विल बी सरप्राइज्ड टू नो दैट दिस इज फ्रॉम अ स्टेट व्हिच हैज नथिंग टू डू विद तिब्बतियन कल्चर राइट बिकॉज दे से एंड हाउ डू वी नो व्हेन एनीबॉडी विल से चलो तिब्बतियन फूड खाने चलते हैं तो वी थिंक अबाउट मोमोज एंड वी इवन डोंट नो दैट मोमोज इज नॉट समथिंग व्हिच इज एसोसिएटेड विद तिब्बतियन फूड यू गॉट माय पॉइंट Look at that. Lovely hair cutting salon, body massage. Right? आप आगे पढ़िए और मुझे बताइए ये क्या है? Yes. It was supposed to be manicure, pedicure. Right? But look at that word there. They have become manicure, pedicure. Right? Now, this is from Haryana. They cannot avoid the tone which is there. How they talk to? Ara chhora khate ja rahe ho sir. Right? So when that tone comes with these very heavy tones, immediately manicure had to be like this. You could not avoid it. Right? Look at that. Vegetable juice. Right? It was supposed to be vegetable juice, but it became something else. Upar padhiye. Barf ka dippo. Fresh vegetable juice, right? Okay, look at that. Ladies and right? Google. Ear, eyebrow, punching ki jati hai, right? Hindi and English. Then perfume, neo, and accessories. This is something which can give a heart attack when you right? The good thing is the person has consistently made mistake, which is a beautiful thing. You be wrong, that be consistently. Right? Now, by the way, we are laughing. Yes, it is meant for laughing. That's why I'm showing you this. But please try to understand this. Are these people illiterate, or is it that the society they come from, the way they speak and pronounce a word, this is how they are writing there on the board? Right? And
एंड व्हाट चेंज इट इज ब्रिंगिंग इन सोसाइटी, ये आपको सब तरफ मिलेगा, पूरे भारत में मिलेगा। इसको पढ़ के देखिए, ये कंपनी में लगा हुआ था एंड आई पर्सनली टुक द फोटो बिकॉज़ आई फाउंड इट सो इंटरेस्टिंग। लंका के पास देखिए मैनेजमेंट ने लिखा, क्या लिखा, वी कांट कुक आवर मीट राइट नाउ, सॉरी फॉर द इनकन्वीनियंस, बट वी स्टिल हैव चिकन टू सर्व, सॉरी अगेन। मुझे कुछ नहीं समझ में आया, राइट? Yes, I could understand what they wanted to say, but the way they have put it, and it is supposed to be a very, very sophisticated a restaurant just near the gate of Lanka, right? And I was just smiling, and that person will talk to you with such nice smile and all that, so you don't feel like telling that person that whatever you have written is wrong. I never told him, right? So look at the impact of the social, because Banarasi people find it difficult to speak English. ये पुलिस प्रशासन, देखिए सड़क सुरक्षा पुलिस के द्वारा लिखा, क्या लिखा है, सेक्रेटरी आरटीए सोनीपत, सोनीपत आपको पता है ना, हरियाणा वाला एरिया, वहां सबसे कमाल की इंग्लिश मिलती है, सजीव प्रादेशिक सर्विस प्राधिकरण सोनीपत, ड्राइव केयरफुली। अब इसको पढ़िए, 90% ऑफ ऑल पीपल आर कॉज्ड बाय एक्सीडेंट्स। वेल, he wanted to say that 90% of the deaths in India are caused by accident, instead of saying, and it's by police, right? Our Department of India which has put this, but by mistake, क्योंकि उन्होंने अपने हरियाणवी लैंग्वेज में सोचा उसको और ऐसा कैसा लिख दिया, 90% of all people are caused by accidents, right? It was supposed to be vice versa with a lot of better explanation. Look at that. For Hindi movies, because you are accepting it for Hindi movies, not English movies. Now look at that. Main hero, side hero. Main side heroine and character role neta, specter and villain. Male and female artist, requirement age 18 to 55 years. Shutting starts 30th March. Right? Now, if you are a student of social linguistics, as I watch very carefully, immediately this word told me from where it is. There is one part in India where they do not say work, they say buh. So when there will be villain, they'll say villain. Bhaiya ji. Right? And yes, this is Bengali culture which has come down from West Bengal to the lower area of Nepal and UP where it touches till even Bihar. Right? So Bhaiya ji became pretty famous in Bihar and this bah is taken up from there. Right? Look at that. Bro, be Mr. Late or Late Mr. Now, this is not wrong English. It is just an amazing message which is given like this way. Try to understand this. First, they are talking to you as the modern English. They are not saying gentleman or sir. They are saying bro. Right? Can you even imagine where was it? It was in the northeastern part where a lot of bullet guys, you know. So, they are talking to them as bro. Right? What is that? Be Mr. Late. Hindi mein ek kahawat hai, durghatna se der bhali. Right? Ki देर हो जाए कोई बात नहीं, पर दुर्घटना तो नहीं है, उसी का ट्रांसलेट कर दिया, बी मिस्टर लेट, नॉट लेट मिस्टर। लेट कब लगाते हैं नाम के आगे, जब आप सॉरी वर्ड्स बोलते हैं, व्हेन यू आर डैड, सो डोंट बी अ लेट मिस्टर, बी मिस्टर लेट। पीपल विल से ओ यू आर मिस्टर लेट, यू ऑलवेज कम लेट, फाइन, दिस वाज द लिटरल ट्रांसलिटरेशन फ्रॉम दुर्घटना से देर, बट इन अ वेरी मॉडर्न अवतार, राइट? This is few of my favorite amazing things. Look at that. Breakfast, lunch, and dinner. The restaurant is telling you that if you will have breakfast at our place, you will be launched after eating that kind of breakfast and then come back after dinner. Right? Now look at this. This is not about language, social existence. लगातार घंटी न बजाएं, आने वाला चलकर आएगा उड़कर नहीं। So it was in front of a long building, right? So they said that everybody always rings the bell. If the time a person will walk down, it takes some time. He has literally put it, getting irritated maybe, and he said, आने वाला चक्कर लगा कर आएगा उठ के नहीं. चलिए, फिर एक संस्कृत में श्लोक लिखा हुआ था नीचे, जिसका मतलब शायद कुछ और होता है, but उसको English में कैसे translate किया हुआ? Spit in your own pocket. Right? You don't spit here. So instead of saying don't spit here, they have said spit in your own pocket. I don't know. Some of you can tell me what does it mean. Swatajya Kishan Tukave. I don't know what does it mean. Now look at that. Ulti karne par 50 rupees. Right? You cannot vomit at a place. If you will vomit, 50 rupees fine. Look at this. Super saloon, dye, facial, masses, and children cutting here. That was something which immediately got me. Children cutting here. Now this can be a very, very violent saloon. These are not something which I have made. Right? I just compiled them together for a study, a paper I had published about what kind of funny advertisements and hoardings are all around us. Right? And why? Should we laugh on them or should we be concerned? Because it's consistently present across India. Not at one region, everywhere in India you will find them. Now these are three of my favorites by English teachers. Ek teacher ne angrezi ki academy kholi hai, dekhi kya likha hai. Smart English speaking with innovative teaching methods. We are having three levels. Zero level. One who does not know how to read, write and speak English, we starts. देखिए English देखिए, we starts from A B C, right? First level, one who know to read, write but can't understand. And second level, one who know to read, write and speak but can't speak correctly. Right? Now it's very difficult to understand the meaning, but as a Hindi speaker, I know what he wanted to say. He just took everything from Hindi. Thereby, ये तीन तरह के लोग होते हैं इंडिया में. एक अंग्रेजी zero है, अंग्रेजी में zero होते हैं. उसको he made it zero level. Then at a better level, first level and second level. And he made it an advertisement. Right? Look at the next advertisement. Bhanu Coaching Center. Right? What should catch your eye is this. हिरोशिमा शहर को जो उड़ा दे उसे परमाणु कहते हैं. गधे को भी जो ढाई महीने में पढ़ा के बैंक का पीओ बना दे उसे भानु कहते हैं. Right? So the teacher's name is Bhanu. And to catch the eye of the students, he has given such a vibrant one. And look at this next one. Again, a teacher, he wants students to join. What he says is, अगर आपके सोच से 100 गुना ज्यादा अच्छा नहीं पढ़ाऊंगा तो मुझे किसी चौराहे पर जिंदा जला दे. I am not sure if you will hear it or not. Maybe I'll send you a link. I wanted to also play one video, which is from a very interesting movie, Fas Gaye Re Obama. Dekhiye aapne se kisi ne? Right? It is one movie for sociolinguistic perspective all of you should watch. Right? If you will move around in India, right? When you will go to Punjab, every second shop there will be IELTS training. Go to Canada, right? Every second shop. There are bookshops and one kind of book is sold there, IELTS. Because every student after 12 wants to go to Canada. You know, I don't know if you're aware or not that, Punjabis mostly have settled in Canada. And Canadian government also has opened up their doors for them, right? Now, these are also part of the sociolinguistic analysis, right? Now comes the question. Whatever you have seen is all prevalent across the country. Why are we making such mistakes? Are they thinking from their mother tongue? Is it wrong to have the influence of mother tongue? Or is it wrong to write something or speak something until you are not reasonable? Mera aim kya tha? Kahi to aapne dekha na? Arth ka anarth ban gaya. Wo galat message. राइट। अगर आप कंपैरेटिवली अपना मैसेज दे पा रहे हो, जैसे आई हैड टू स्क्रैच माय हेड, वो मैनिक्योर पेडिक्योर वाला था ना, आई कुड नॉट गेस दैट इट्स रिटन मैनिक्योर पेडिक्योर, सो आई वाज थिंकिंग ये क्या लिखा है। देन आई रियलाइज्ड, ओह, दैट आई आस्क्ड द गाय, आई सेड व्हाट इज दिस, व्हाट डू यू डू हियर, ही सेड सर मैनिक्योर पेडिक्योर, पढ़े लिखे नहीं है आप। मैंने कहा अरे सर इंग्लिश थोड़ी मेरी कमजोर है, सॉरी। एंड ही सेड इट विद सो मच ऑफ कॉन्फिडेंस, इसीलिए मैंने बोला था हिंदी में लिखो, गवार लोग आ जाते हैं। And I was looking at his face and he has amazing confidence, right? Now what is wrong? If there is something wrong, should we only laugh and forget about this, or should we do something about this? Are there certain ways in linguistics which can help us to work on that? Yes, I'm not saying that yes, the answer is not going to be yes. But yes, I want to have my leap of faith, and with all of your help, we are going to come with the consensus that yes, there is a way in which if we are at Z, we can come to W or even go further on the reverse trend, so that we can improve little bit. Yes, I do understand how we do that. Let's start from here. Let's try to understand now some basic concepts of social linguistics, with which I hope that we develop a better understanding of it. When you talk about meaning, number one, when you are writing in your exam, you are speaking to your roommate, you are talking to your teachers, your vice chancellor or your friends, remember that the language has different kind of meanings, and the kind of words which you pick up cannot be same for chancellor, vice chancellor, teacher, your roommate or your junior, right? So how many types of languages are there? Referential, we use it to convey message and information. Right? So use very crisp language and you convey your message. Poetic. To indulge in language for its own sake, you know, when you read poetry, right? They will tell you अलंकार लगा लगा. But क्या आप आपस में एक दूसरे से अलंकार लगा लगा के बात करेंगे? We don't do that way. Emotive. To express attitudes, feelings and emotions. Cognitive. To persuade and influence others through commands and requests. Phatic. To establish communication with others, and metalingual, to clear up intentions and meanings. According to me, the most important is this last one. Metalingual, to clear up intentions and meanings. Whenever you say something, do not worry if you have deleted and omitted one helping verb. So instead of saying she is going, you can say she going, I coming, you eating, let's reading. Fine. Still it's wrong English, but it is capable to at least express your message. Right? What happens sometimes, I have seen when students make presentations. They come prepared. I can see their preparation. And for that, I'm a big fan of this university. The students are very, very, very sincere and hardworking. But there is a problem. The problem is that they lose their confidence very easily. Right? So you come there and suddenly to impress somebody, you start to think about big, big words. Right? And because you are looking for big words, you forget one thing, that language is used for communication. And the selection of the words should be something with which you can easily communicate yourself. Don't try to show off your knowledge of English. That is not because you need to know our audience. Who is your audience? According to audience, always write. Now, when you write in your exam, who is going to read your answer sheet? Teachers. And supposedly, their language is going to be better than you. That's why they are your teachers. That's where we expect academic English from you. But when you are writing a mail to your friend, who is almost of your same age, right? Do we expect any academic English from you? No, right? When you are reading legal studies, for instance, a student from Sovarikpa, student from Fine Arts, the students who are reading Fine Arts, their vocabulary is little bit different, right? They know what is surrealism, what is, you know, Dadaism, what is cubism and all those words which other students will not. The students of literature know what is metaphor, what is simile, what is metonymy, what is alliteration and so on and so forth. Why do we know that? Because remember, we all belong to different registers. Right? So one advice let me give to all of you. If you ever have this idea in your mind that sir, I want to improve my English, now what kind of books I should read? Let me give it with a solution and an assurance so that you understand. never directly go and read newspapers ever. Never go to big, big, bulky novels, because we always will finish it always after a month. What should you do? Read a good history book. Why? Because a history book will start writing, telling you about history from our ancient, let's say, since the inception of civilization. They will use the vocabulary, the name of the implements and the stuff which was used in that era, and you will know a vocabulary of that era. Right? Then, where you will read history of the world, you will read some certain vocabulary about England, certain vocabulary about America, certain vocabulary about everything. Then when you will come into historical era, like Renaissance, Medievalism, Enlightenment, colonization, every era has different vocabulary. Then when you will come in modern era, they will tell you about medicine science, engineering, culture studies, literature, everything. Once read a very good history book, so that you will be capable to see that societies have been capable to evolve, introduce, get affected by different kinds of English. You will see, for instance, a word like Holocaust. Right? You go to a dictionary, you will not find the real meaning of Holocaust, because according to me, you cannot understand Holocaust by understanding the definition of this. For instance, the word partition. Right? आप डिक्शनरी खोलिए, पार्टीशन का क्या मीनिंग मिलेगा? विच पार्ट समथिंग, मैं इस कमरे में या एक लकड़ी का कुछ लगा दूं तो पार्टीशन हो गया वो, राइट? बट व्हेन आई रीड 1947 हिस्ट्री ऑफ इंडिया एंड पाकिस्तान, देन आई डू अंडरस्टैंड द मीनिंग ऑफ दैट वर्ड. इट कैन नॉट बी इन वन सेंटेंस. इट इज अबाउट इमोशंस. यू गॉट माय पॉइंट व्हाट आई एम ट्राइंग टू से? सो प्लीज डू रीड अ गुड हिस्ट्री बुक, हिस्ट्री ऑफ द होल वर्ल्ड. And trust me, when you will be capable to see the variety of Englishes laying down there, you will be capable to appreciate and feel confident about your own use of English. Right? That also comes under sociolinguistics, because here, the society, the various societies of different countries are in front of your eyes. Right? What are variations according to the use of language? I just give you a few examples. Idiolect, style, रजिस्टर, जार्गन. जैसे रजिस्टर के बारे में थोड़ा सा बात करते हैं, बिकॉज इट्स वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. मोस्ट ऑफ यू हियर, दोज हु आर द स्टूडेंट्स हियर, योर रजिस्टर इज दिस, राइट? सो द काइंड ऑफ वोकैबुलरी व्हिच यू यूज ड्यूरिंग योर प्रेजेंटेशन, ड्यूरिंग एनीथिंग, राइट? फॉर इंस्टेंस, यस्टरडे आई हैड गॉन टू डिलीवर अ लेक्चर एट आईआईटी बीएचयू, एंड व्हेन आई मेट द स्टूडेंट्स देयर, दे ऑल यूज टेक्नोलॉजिकल लैंग्वेज. Right? So they were telling me, but sir, that idea of culture and society does not sync together. And I knew that when they use the word sync, from where that word is coming. Right? They will not say something like it is having its reflection or a resonance. They say, sir, but it has a superimposition on that. I knew that it's a technical student who is talking about superimposition in that sense. Right? So we all have certain registers. What you should do is, you are comfortable with the register? Fair enough. Now go across your register and try to read the vocabulary and English of different registers also. That's what you find in history book. Right? Or what you can do is, very soon we are also going to start a documentary club here in this university. Right? We are going to change your Atisha Hall into a kind of mini theater for all of you. I have made, with a lot of hard work, with a long list of all the authentic documentaries we'll be showing. And first documentary which we are going to show you is the history of the world, right? It's a beautiful documentary made by BBC, and it's going to end after every documentary of 45 minutes. We are going to give you 10 to 15 minutes lecture on the words, culture, vocabulary, ideas which you learned from that. Right? This is how sociolinguistics is capable to help you to change your registers also. I hope you understand what is register. Others, sometimes, you know, there are a lot of things. I hate linguistics for one thing, that it has its own register. It, you, unimportantly, sometimes has certain words which make no sense to me, at least, because I'm very critical of their use. So don't worry about, don't try to learn all of them, that, oh, I need to know what is the meaning of that. Try to understand that. If they are not useful for you, leave them aside. Right? A student should not read everything. A student should know what not to read and what to read. Right? Let's read some sentences. ये पहले वाला भूल जाइए, sentence पढ़ के देखते हैं. पांच sentences हैं यहाँ पे, देखिए क्या है. I want to welcome you to the Closer Connection Conference sponsored in part by Dakota TESL and SDAL. Right? आपको एक कॉन्फ्रेंस में आए तो ऐसे ही बोलते हैं. We would like to welcome all of you at our campus and on behalf of kids, we would like to welcome and so right? दूसरा देखिए. Good morning. I will let Dr. Jones know you are here. Right? Somebody on reception said, good morning. I'll let the Dr. Johnson say. Okay. Next. Hello, Mr. Smith. How are you doing this morning? Next. Hey, Jack. What's up? Last. How is my little puppy today? Right? It is not about the dog. It is a human being is talking to another human being. Now, don't ask me who was talking to whom. I hope that you attend enough to get up. Now, look at this. Everywhere there is right English, but the registers have chosen. Right? So, there are these five types of register. One is known as frozen register, which has a same kind of English. So if you're an anchor, like I did a lot of anchoring my student here, right? Today as a teacher, when I stand up, I immediately say, I would like to welcome all of you. So much so, ki jab kabhi main Deepavali pe ghar jata hoon, right? Aur Deepavali pe baat karni hoti hai, I talk like this to my parents. I would like to welcome all of you on this Diwali gathering of family. And they say, my family, look at me. How are you talking? You're not in the university. You're not doing anything. You are in a family. Talk in a language family can understand. Right? Because it has got frozen. I have got accustomed to this. Sometimes even I don't know. I'm not listening what I'm saying. Right? Formal. This is what you talk when you're talking to your seniors. Right? Whenever you talk at a public gathering. Right? So the language, even in Tibetan, the language with which you will talk to Vice Chancellor has to be different from the language you will talk to your friend in a hostel room. Right? Then you have consultative. Right? Look at that word, consultative. It's a consultation. Hello, Mr. Smith, how are you doing this morning? Right? Look at this, casual. This is about friends. Right? Among friends, you say, hey, Jack. Look at the tone also. I'm not only talking about selection of word, tone. Hey, Jack, what's up, buddy? Right? Can you go to your vice chancellor and say, hey, DC, what's up, buddy? That can be something which even does not sound proper to all of us. It's like blasphemy. You can't do that. Right? And last is very intimate. You do it with your very, very close friends. Right? So we have a joke in social linguistics. I literally did a personal research on this. I'm not talking about here, right? The university I was teaching earlier was a co-ed where a lot of flirting around and ever will go between boys and girls. And boys are at the end of the day boys. What do? They will have 3-4 girlfriends and everybody's name they will say by baby. Right? To the most, baby one, baby two, baby three. Let's say if anybody is calling, you don't know who is calling, so you'll say, hey baby. And next one will think, hey, mere se hi. Right? So what do? They never use your proper name. They will not say Mahesh, Sunita, Anita, Vinita. Because if Sunita ko Vinita bol diya, isliye kya karo? Naam ko replace karke common adjective use. Right? Baby, honey. Right? And that language has now it has become a standard language, though intimate, but it is still a register of it. And from where it has got so much of popularity, it has got popularity from Hollywood movies. Right? From the soap operas like you watch. I don't know you watch. Have you watched Friends? Friends is a series which is crazy across the globe. Right? I watched it. Let's say this is one of that series which is in 10-year long length. I have watched it more than, when I say trust me, I mean it, more than 30 times. Whenever I travel in trains or buses and all, I want to kill my time. I always kill my time with watching Friends. It's an interest. You get addicted to this. And I know what sociolinguistically it has done to my English language. Immediately when I'm in an intimate circle with my family, right, I use that intimate English immediately. Right? So we'll also have to understand what kind of books you are reading. When you make a presentation in front of us, we know what kind of books you are reading, what kind of friends you have, what kind of circle of people are around you who speak English if at all they do. That's why I tell here, and I'm openly saying this, and please tell me if I'm wrong. Here the problem is not that all of you are not capable to speak English. It is because you do not speak English. Even not in English classes. Forget about going outside and you immediately come to Tibetan language. I am not against that. Please try to understand. I am saying it's absolutely fine. We all should be proud. Right? All I am saying is that at least for 1 hour, half an hour, in a particular setting, speak in English to each other. So that first you feel comfortable with each other. Then you will be comfortable in front of a teacher. Right? I don't know I should say or not, but still I'll say. Yesterday I was at IIT BHU and I gave a lecture. So a teacher came to me and he said, "Arey sir, aap wahan Tibetan Institute mein kya kar rahe hain? Aapko to BHU mein hona chahiye." And I could understand what he wants to say. I said, "Why?" बोले अरे सर एक बार वहां से अंग्रेजी की कॉपियां मेरे पास आ गई चेक करने के लिए. मैंने तो हाथ जोड़ लिए सर. मैंने उनको लिखा कि वहां के अंग्रेजी के बच्चों की कॉपियां मुझे मत भेजना. एंड आई वाज सो अशेम्ड. आई वाज एंग्री. आई वाज हेल्पलेस. आई वाज अशेम्ड. एंड एट द सेम टाइम आई मेड अ प्रॉमिस टू माई सेल्फ. और मैंने उन्हें ही की बात की. मैंने कहा हाँ सर आवर किड्स आर नॉट सो गुड. यस दे मेक अ लॉट ऑफ मिस्टेक. आई माई सेल्फ हैव प्रॉब्लम चेकिंग देयर आंसर शीट्स. बट आई प्रॉमिस यू That campus is changing, and you wait for a couple of years, the students of that campus will be presenting something in front of the teachers. Right? Why I'm sharing this thing with you? Because we are interlinked. My identity is linked with you, with that place. When you fall, I fall as a teacher. Right? And I'm only talking about English here because that's what I do. That's what I can do. When I go somewhere and my name comes there, immediately my identity is main kahan pe padhata hun. Right? If I'm doing a good work, people will tell me, "Wahan kyun padha rahe ho, sir?" Right? Because what are they saying, which is absent? They are saying maybe that place is not good for English. Yes, it's good for. Then the same man told me, "Ki sir, wo campus bada shant aur bada badhiya hai, sir." Right? Main agar apni zindagi retirement ke baad main kahin kaatna chahunga na sir, to wahan pe kaatna. I said, "Sir, that is not a Vrdha Ashram or something. It's an institute, and that campus is famous for 1,000 things in India, which no other campus is famous for. And yes, sir, so far as English is concerned, I apologize. But trust me, that campus one day will change. Now, I did a promise there on your behalf. You may also find the same kind of expression when sometime you will go outside. The problem is, you guys don't go outside of your community. If at all you want to make presentation, you go to the places where you are comfortable with. Please go outside of your community. Make presentations at IIT, at least in this place, BHU, right? Converse with the English students there, and then you will know where you should improve. You got my point? This is social linguistics. You cannot be part of this secluded society here. You are not competing only with here. You are competing on a global level. So you will have to compete with global realities. To compete with global realities, right? And I met the students there, which are Tibetan students in BHU. And trust me, they have improved a lot. Two of them were my students. I just joined a year back in this university. Right? I still remember those two boys who from Uttar Madhyama had joined BHU. Again, right? Struggling there, but I can see a change in his confidence there. And you know what is the difference? The difference is, breaking a register, breaking your comfort level, going out of comfort level and let other people know, falter, fall down, but at least try for it. Until your social realities will change, you are not going to change at all. Sitting comfortably in this room where you feel comfortable, I talk to you, you talk to me, we laugh and we go and we sleep, is not going to change the reality. Right? Please try to understand what I'm saying. Please think about this, what I'm saying. Right? And I am ready to take that responsibility that your identity, your future, your careers are immediately attached with us. And we are ready to do whatever you wish us to do. You want us to again start a everyday workshop from tenses? I am ready to do that till here 5 o'clock. Aap batao hume. Right? But mehnat kijiye. Varna, jo duniya jis speed se badal rahi hai na, ek din aap log archaic ho jaoge, outdated ho jaoge. मैं किसी के इंसल्ट के हिसाब से नहीं बोल रहा हूँ. प्लीज डोंट टेक मी अदरवाइज. राइट? आई एम योर टीचर. आई डू अंडरस्टैंड. वी कम फ्रॉम डिफरेंट कम्युनिटी. आई गो आउटसाइड एवरीवेयर आई डिलीवर टॉक्स. राइट? And I feel proud that I'm associated with this university. My first slide is always in big letter that I teach at Central University of Higher Philippines. I'm very proud of that. But then the same pride I want to see among our students. Whatever is the problem, you want us to start from scratch? Let's do it together. Let's sit down, even 20 people, and I'll start from tenses. But don't let any bloody teacher tell me ever at other places that, sir, your students' answer sheets, we don't want to check. I don't want to hear this next time. It makes me very angry. Shouldn't I be angry? I could dismiss it. I could say, ah, sir, hamare to bache aise hi hain, sir. I could dismiss it. I deny to dismiss it. Because I don't see any reason why any one of you is not capable to surprise anybody else across the world. Right? You are healthy, hearty, everything is great. Have a great campus. We all are around you. Tell us what you need from us. We don't want gold medalists in our classes. But we need students who are capable to change the reality in society around you. That day you will understand what is social injustice. Not only teaching this and making notes, it's not going to be that. Right? That was something which was on emotive way, emotional. But I hope that you can associate it with that. And understand this, that why I am so angry with this. Anyway, not important, so let's skip this. Yes, this is something, a very interesting idea. Speech communities. What do you think? What are speech communities? And how speech communities are formed together? How speech communities are formed together? For instance, you are a speech community. Right? When I am a non-Tibetan, I am out of your speech community. But when now I am talking in English, in this lecture, I am also part of your speech community. Right? So we have speech communities, which are group of people of any social class, students, workers, or even friends and families. Right? Now, every speech community has to understand it, that you mix with other speech communities and you create a language, just in English, mein bolte hain, Creole, Creolization. Let's talk about one reality. Let's go 100 years back and think about this. कि इंडिया का एक आदमी पहली बार कुछ चीज बेचने गया होगा चाइना के एक आदमी को, तो कौन सी लैंग्वेज में बात की होगी?
साइन।
नहीं, मैं इतने भी पुराना। Right? That means you need a language. Surprisingly, and that's what social be aware of this. Surprisingly, the marketplaces. The commercial market and especially जो बॉम्बे का पोर्ट है, कैलकटा का पोर्ट है और चेन्नई का पोर्ट है ना, आपको हर राज्य का एक आदमी वहां मिलेगा and they speak tutti frutti English. Right? 50 kg banana, you want, I give, you don't want, get lost. Right? No grammar, no problem. We call it creolization. This is a formation. Without standard grammar, when two people who come from different speech communities start to converse each other, let it be broken English, right? But as long as they can express their views to each other, we call it creolization. And I love this process of creolization because this is how languages evolve, right? This is how some languages take immediately a word. How? Out of encounter of two different speaking communities, a new language comes. We call it Pidgin English, P-I-D-G-I-N. Right? It is also outcome. It's a product of creolization. So speech communities, this we can skip. Yeah, this we can talk because this is something is associated with all of you. There are a few communities which we call tight communities. Right? There are a few communities which are known as loser community. Look at the title of our university, Central Institute of Higher Tibetan Studies. Right? Anybody, whenever I go outside, they ask me, sir, aapke sare student Tibetan hai? Mujhe bhi lagta tha 6 mahine pehle. Ki haan bhai, Tibetan university mein padhata hu. Phir then I made a padlet and my students started to share with me. I came to know that there are very less students from Tibet and there are a lot of from Himalayan. But then our students, our university's name is not that. Right? Then besides that, what has happened? Whenever you converse only in your community. Sahi bol raha hu na? So you are part of a tight community. You do not loosen up, go have common friends, even you don't cross this sacred Varuna Nadi and go in that side of the city to talk to people and students. You don't go into conferences, seminars at BHU, at IIT, BHU, at Allahabad University, Delhi University, because you are here. Am I saying anything wrong? Right? Fear of what? Fear of first going out of that comfort zone of yours, that tight community. Here you think ki aap sab Raja Babu. I'm ready to accept that. I'm saying that you call yourself Raja Babu when you go outside and prove that equally. Right? So there are few communities where language has not evolved a lot if you live in a tight community. Right? Aap kabhi ek halka sa research karna ho na social linguistics ko. The best thing is you go to different campuses of India. Delhi, DU University mein jaiye and you will find a kya rahe, kya karta, right? And you will find every kind of Hindi and English there because a cosmopolitan kind of society is there. Here, our language is not growing. Why it is not growing? Because you do not have interaction with any other community besides your own. And I find it a big hurdle. What we can do? I'm not saying let other communities come in our university. We are absolutely fine. Let our students go in other communities and have an exchange. Exchange of ideas. Exchange of thoughts. You talk. You discuss so that you learn from other vocabulary and you let other people learn about you. So the difference between in social linguistics. You have learned language now. Let's say English ke basics ab aapko aate hain. Practice to karna padega na. Right? The student hamesha ek excuse dete hain. Sir, English ka environment hi nahi hai. Dekho kitna achha environment hai. Right? Aisa kuch nahi hota English ka environment. Hum koi Alaska mein nahi reh rahe. Right? Environment chahiye aapko. Right? Apni language ko kabhi mat bhuliye. I'm very proud I speak Hindi, I write in Hindi. But at the same time, languages hai ye to. Main keh raha hu English kyun? Aap French seekhiye, aap German seekhiye, aap foreign languages bhi seekhiye. Language to language hoti hai, kya fark padta usse? Right? And then when you learn, trust me, as a teacher I'm telling you, as your senior I'm telling you, I have learned it a hard way. Your language is going to be. Because then, you are capable to compare. Today, आज मैं हिंदी लिटरेचर में कुछ पढ़ता हूँ, अंग्रेजी लिटरेचर में पढ़ाता हूँ, मैं immediately compare करता हूँ, right? जब यहाँ छायावाद पढ़ता हूँ, I know what was there in English literature. Your language is going to grow. It is going to enrich. The vocabulary is going to enrich, right? So you have to come out of tight community and be part of loose community. Internal languages, external languages, these things. Yeah, this is something pretty interesting. We can discuss about this idea. When we talk about change in languages, right? I asked you this question. That let's pick up Tibetan language also as an example. क्या आप आज भी तिब्बतियन लैंग्वेज में वही एक्सप्रेशन यूज करते हैं जो 1800 में या 16वीं शताब्दी में या 19 या 20th सेंचुरी में यूज करते थे? No. Just scare them off. Do shoo shoo, they'll go. Right? No. Languages change. Now, languages change on how many fronts? They change phonetically, morphologically, semantically, syntactically and other features. Let me discuss this point with you. Can any one of you, based on your observation, can tell me ki achha aapki Tibetan language mein kya badla hai? Kya badla hai? Thodi modernize hui hai? Thodi English aur Hindi se kuch words aap lene lage ho? Kya badla ho? Ya thoda less religious ho gayi? Ha? Tone has changed? Okay, when you live in another country that always happens. Tone has changed. Okay, what else has changed? Sorry? And where you have adopted those words from? What is the source?
I mean, some words like butting.
Okay.
Butting. We say, for buttocks we say like butting. I think it's mixture of buttocks and ting.
Okay.
For example, budding is not English word. It's not Hindi. Hindi, what do you call for budding?
You are saying but?
Bucket.
You are talking about Balti, right? Bucket is Balti.
Oh, yeah, that is called Balti.
Balti.
So we have, since we came to India, there's changes of so many words like Balti and Tariki.
Okay.
Tariki, we say Tariki, Tariki. But in Islam, we don't.
Okay. Anybody else? What has changed over the years, the way you speak? Because you might have come from different places where Tibetan is spoken, and then you came here, you are living for, let's say, 5-6 years. Any change? I find it pretty interesting. What do you do when you go outside somewhere? I see our students into malls and all, you know. Amazing thing. So, how do you communicate, especially those who do not know Hindi? How do you communicate with people? Right? While the most important thing, how other people look at you? How rickshawala looks at you? With what intention? Isko loot lete hain. Be surprised if you don't want to. सारे ऑप्शन बात कीजिए और मैं देखिए कोई अनरियल सररियल बात नहीं करता हूँ. मैं भी सोसाइटी में रहता हूँ. वी ऑल्सो ऑब्जर्व पीपल. वी ऑलवेज ऑब्जर्व. मैं रोज बीएचयू से यहाँ आता हूँ, राइट? रोड पे इतनी दुकानें हैं, मुझे नहीं दिखती. बट कोई भी चीज बहुत बड़ी या बहुत छोटी हो या अलग कलर की आ जाए, रोड पे हाथी आ रहा है तो मेरा ध्यान जाएगा. बट रोड पे बसेस और ट्रेन, सॉरी कार आ रही है तो मेरा ध्यान नहीं जाएगा. बट रोड पे ट्रेन आ जाएगी तो ध्यान जाएगा, राइट? जब हमें कुछ डिफरेंट दिखता है, हमारा ध्यान उधर जाता है. Then what is the social linguistic way? Either people will cheat them, they will have a pity towards them, or they will try to take use of them. Right? So you discuss this for first. Start to go outside. Learn to go outside, not in a risky manner. कि आप बोलो संजय बोला था बाहर जाना है, रात को 12 बजे जाके अपने स्टेशन पे बैठ जाओ. I'm not saying that. Go out of tight community and please think social linguistically. How you are being seen by other people, observed by other people. The gaze of the eyes is capable to tell you 10 things. If you talk to a person whose language you don't understand, how do you communicate? How do you do? How do you start? First, a willingness should be there from both of you that you should do. Right? If you are, और क्या problem आती है? Problem के solution क्या है? अगर आपको ये चीजें समझ में आ गई तो आज का lecture समझ. You don't have to understand theories of social linguistics for that, right? And remember, if you are 10 days going continuously outside, remember, with surety I can tell you, you will pick up one new word in your language, or your language will be picked up by somebody else, and we always exchange the ideas and languages like this. This is how languages grow. This is how languages evolve. Right? Recently, I found it very interesting to see that there are a lot of very funky Western music videos by Tibetan across globe, especially those who are living in US and all. And they look like amazingly picturized with all the Western amenities. You understand what I'm trying to say, right? Which is an amazing change which is coming in this community. Right? Okay. Language change. What are the causes for that? ये देखिए, ये वर्ड देखिए. She is क्या बन गया? She is. We have been. We have been. Right? जैसे एक वर्ड था got it, क्या बन गया? Gotcha. Right? So languages also change. In what sense? Economy. We try to use, जैसे आप होने लग गया, आप जो टाइप करते हैं you are, YOUR क्या हो गया? You are. Right? We use. And this is not anything wrong. This is how languages are changing. WhatsApp and new technology has a big impact on our social linguistic way. The way we type, we understand. Analogy. Analogy is when you compare one word and then you compare it with another word and you reduce the words together. Right? Jaise maan lijiye, aap bahar kuch khareedne gaye. The interesting experience is always with vegetable seller or fruit seller. Right? And let's say you are struggling ki isko kya kehte hain, usko kya kehte hain, then of course your mind will always think about a Tibetan word for that. Will it not happen? It will happen. Whenever you will go, they will say it's lemon, it's banana, it's this, it's that. Immediately your mind will try to find a word. Right? This is analogical vocabulary. This is how we think when we are in a social media. Right? Ab problem kaha aayegi? Abhi main aapko lecture de raha hu sociolinguistics pe. Can you tell me what is it in a Tibetan language? Are you trying to translate it or is there exactly a word available? Don't answer me because anyhow I'll not understand. I'm saying think about this. In that time, the reality is a little bit distant and you are not capable to attach to it. Right? This is, look at that, a language context. Languages come into contact with each other. I just gave you the example. The most common way that languages influence each other is exchange of word. Right? Just aap Banaras mein 80 ghat ke aas paas jaiye. I one day had this at one of the restaurants. Sushi. Right? Do you know what is sushi? Have you ever eaten this? It's very close to made of rice and what you call they had a name for this, I have forgotten it, right? Very close to this. But the way they have presented it and the way they cook it, they call it sushi. But now it's not a Japanese word. For instance, pizza. Is there anybody on this Mother Earth who does not know the word pizza? Anybody in this class, by the way, I am exaggerating a lot. Anybody in this class who doesn't know pizza, raise your hand. Thank God, I was not wrong. Right, we all know. So though it is an Italian word, but because of certain reasons, it has become so famous that languages have started to exchange like this. Right? Now I always say, can you force the rest of the world to know how many types of teas you have in your culture? Or let them know about some of the words from your culture? Now comes the question, how will you do that? How cultures do that? Is it the language of advertisement, language of movies, language via songs, literature? How will you do that? All of these. The examples which I gave, you write or start to sing an English song, but somewhere in that English song have one word of your own language, the world will go crazy about it. Trust me for that. And this is how you be global. But act locally. Your feet are still deeply rooted in your culture, but you are capable to touch and appeal at the global level. Right? I do remember when in my initial BA, I was reading a book by Raja Rao, a very interesting Sanskrit scholar who started to write in English. And when he had written the works in English, the way he has written English is like Sanskrit. We don't speak Sanskrit, we recite Sanskrit. संस्कृत को बोलते नहीं, संस्कृत को, संस्कृत एक गेय भाषा है, गा के सुनाते हैं. उनकी इंग्लिश इज एग्जैक्टली लाइक दैट. एज इफ आई एम स्पीकिंग अ श्लोक इन संस्कृत, आई एम गोइंग टू रिसाइट दैट इंग्लिश. ही हैज डन इज फोनेटिकली एंड इट्स एन अमेजिंग बुक. रीड राजा राव्स बुक, यू विल अंडरस्टैंड व्हाट आई एम सेइंग. राइट? सो दिस इज हाउ दिस लैंग्वेज कॉन्टेक्ट वर्क्स. राइट? लेट्स हैव एन एग्जांपल. सो वन विल बी डोनेट लैंग्वेज, वन विल बी रिसीवर लैंग्वेज. सो लुक एट दैट. French loans in English in law, right? हम French loans, right? वहाँ पे mother-in-law और उनको loans, ये वो loan नहीं है जिसको loan पे लेते हैं वाला, वो English में आके क्या बन गया? In law, right? Sound was identical. Crime, judge और fashion and food, mirror and mutton, they look like English word but none of them is English. They all have come from other languages from outside. Right? Okay, let's talk about some of the concepts of applied linguistics. Right? Social linguistics is such a broad area, I'll finish in 10 minutes, I promise. It's such a broad area that you will not be capable to cover it. Everything which is associated between society and the language, right, is related with social linguistics. And remember, most of the languages, they have grown from the aspect of society, which is what? Fashion, food items, travel items, name of clothes, in which Tibetan culture is a very, very, very rich culture. Right? English mein hum ek word bolte hain, button. Right? Hindi mein paanch naam hai button ke. And I'm sure there should be 10 types in Tibetan language. Because the kind of clothes and the color combination they use is an amazing thing. But let it not be dying out in a closed community. Right? Write about that, talk about that. And let it go to rest of the world. Let them know what kind of different cultures are available there. Right? Now, how do we apply everything in linguistics is the concern of applied linguistics, the final branch of linguistics, we can say. In a very simple say, in simple way, all those who are in literature classes, you are a student of applied linguistics by default. Right? Whenever you open up a poem, a short story, a novel or a drama, and you try to analyze it, right, you are immediately using the rules of applied linguistics unknowingly, without a training, which is a great thing. Right? I am more concerned just telling you about few things, and then we are going for some exercises here together. So that will make more sense. So what is applied linguistics actually? An interdisciplinary field of study that identifies, investigates and offers solution to language related real life problems. Some of the academic fields related to applied linguistics are education, linguistics, psychology, anthropology and sociology, especially the B.Ed. students. You will have to be very good at social linguistics and applied linguistics, because this is how teachers are going to teach in class. Right? I never get disheartened when students are making mistakes in English. Do make a lot of mistakes, but at least make mistakes. For that you will have to talk, you will have to speak. I get frustrated when you shy away and run away from there. Make mistakes, because I know it is your L2. It's the language which you are learning. It has to be an acquired language. So I'm not expecting to start with anything big, but at least if you want to travel 1,000 kilometers, first thing is you have to take first step. Right? So applied linguistics also talks about that first step from your I hope all of you know these terms like first and second language acquisition. First language is your mother tongue. Please, until you are good or want to feel comfortable in second language acquisition, use that language also in your communication. आप क्या कर रहे हो? आप 24 घंटे में से कितने घंटे सिर्फ तिब्बतियन बोलते हो? ऐसा मत बोलो. ये तो थोड़ा ज़्यादा है. मैं 24 में ना 24 घंटे से. Right? मैं ये नहीं. आप 24 में से 23 घंटे बोलिए. एक घंटे practice कीजिए second language. So that you acquire a little bit of comfort level. Right? So, we call it L2 learning, right? L2 learning and all that. So, there are a lot of things which you can discuss, we can talk, but I'm not going to do that. We are directly coming to, yes, on this. There are a few sentences. Okay? Panch panch karna shuru karte hain. There are some errors in these sentences. You are the students where English is not your mother tongue. Let's first try to find out what is the error and let's try to find out the solution. So, pehla sentence uthate. Look always in the mirror before you start driving. Galat to isme kuch nahi dikh raha. Padhiye sentence ko. Kya problem hai sentence? But isme hi galti hai. Anybody would like to correct it? चलिए आप लिखिए अपनी आंसर शीट में लिखिए जिसको जितना समझ में आ रहा है. What will be everywhere there is a mistake. How will you correct the mistake of first sentence? Don't think too much about grammar. These are not grammatical problems. These are sociolinguistic and applied linguistic problems. Right? Second, here is coming my bus. What is wrong? Here is coming my bus. मैं स्कूल बस का वेट कर रहा हूँ. मेरी बस मुझे दिख गई तो मैं क्या बोलूंगा? Here is coming my bus. क्या गड़बड़ है इस सेंटेंस में? सीक्वेंस शायद एक वर्ड इधर एक वर्ड उधर चला गया. ठीक है, थर्ड की बात करते हैं. It is saying in today's paper that there is going to be another strike. Some of you can note down in your answer sheet, so we'll know what are the answers. I'm going to show you the answers also, don't worry. So we will understand the problem of that language. Right? Panch karenge, panch agli slide ke karenge. Fourth, when I was a child, I was playing a lot of basketball. When I was a child, I was playing a lot of basketball. So far as normal grammar is concerned, that doesn't sound anything which is fishy or wrong. It sounds absolutely fine. There is something wrong in all the sentences. Right? And look at the fifth one. It happened while I stayed in Ireland. Right? पांच को एक बार हल्के से फिर से देखिए, मैं स्लाइड बदल रहा हूँ जिसमें आंसर है, राइट? तो पहला देखिए, आंसर देखेंगे, फिर मैं वापस आऊंगा, दूसरा पढ़ेंगे, आंसर देखेंगे। पहला पढ़िए दिमाग में, तो दिमाग में इतनी जोर से पढ़ते हो, यहाँ तक आवाज आ रही है। अब बढ़िए वापस, ऑलवेज लुक करके देखिए, इसमें कुछ गलत नहीं लग रहा था। लुक ऑलवेज इन द मिरर बिफोर यू स्टार्ट राइटिंग। अब एक बार इसको आगे ले जाके पढ़िए, राइट? नाउ इफ इंग्लिश इज नॉट योर मदर टंग, इट इज वेरी डिफिकल्ट टू फाइंड दिस काइंड ऑफ मिस्टेक, राइट? Now read it. Always look in the mirror before you start writing. Sounds better? अब ये ग्रामर के बारे में नहीं है, ये हमारी सोसाइटी, हम हिंदी में ऐसे ही बोलते हैं, हम ऑलवेज बाद में रख के बोलते हैं, बट इंग्लिश उल्टा करेंगे, इंग्लिश ऑलवेज पहले मांगेंगे। चलिए सेकेंड सेंटेंस पर चलते हैं। Here is coming my bus. I'm sure this you can imagine, right? Here is coming my bus. Here is your answer. Here comes my bus. We don't say here is coming my bus, though the bus is being driven at the moment when you are speaking, but we don't use ing in this. ठीक है? But हम हिंदी में क्या बोलते हैं? ये आ रही है हमारी बस. We do speak in ing, but English you say here comes my bus. Right? A problem? A social linguistic problem. Third. It is saying in today's paper that there is going to be another strike. Look at the answer. Third, it says, right? There is no expression like it is saying. It says, right? Next, fourth, when I was a child, I was playing a lot of basketball. Answer dekh rahe hain? Sirf ek jagah change hoga. When I was a child, I played a lot of basketball. When I was a child, I played. अब पढ़िए दिमाग में, आपको लगेगा हाँ ये better, जबकि आ तो नहीं रहा था better है, right? और इसके लिए you don't have to feel bad. These are tricky statements of social. What now? As students, what we can do? We can sit together sometime after classes, right? और मैं आपको दो तीन books telling होने से कुछ नहीं होगा, that I tell you the name, you'll not do it. We have to have certain workshop, regular classes, at least have once in a week. But भागिए मत इससे, आगे आइए, हमें बोलिए, right? Let it go through via Student Welfare Association that sir, we need some classes. There is so much in English which we can do together, and at least that 1 hour which you might have spent sleeping down or lazing around somewhere, you can use it. I know you are too busy. I absolutely understand when students here have that fatigue face here ki sir, sare din hamari baji lehti hai. I do understand that. But at the same time, remember the promise which I made to somebody. Right? For that, I am also ready to take the responsibility. All of you will have to come forward 20 sentences per day. Aur fir main kya karunga? Uske piche ki grammar bhi aapko bataunga. Tab aapko grammar ke, grammar kabhi ulta mat padhiye. रूल्स पढ़िए, जैसे डॉक्टर लिखता है एक गोली सुबह ले लेना एक शाम को और बस, ऐसे ग्रामर, ग्रामर इज नॉट प्रिस्क्रिप्टिव, ग्रामर इज एनालिटिकल एंड प्रैक्टिकल इन द क्लासेस। लेट्स स्ट्रगल विद द सेंटेंस एंड विद एवरी सेंटेंस आई टेल यू द ग्रामेटिकल रूल्स। अगर एक सेमेस्टर में हमने 1000 सेंटेंसेस भी पढ़ लिए, यू आर डूइंग अ लिटिल बिट बेटर, राइट? दैट्स व्हाट वी शुड डू, दिस इज अप्लाइड लिंग्विस्टिक्स, राइट? मैं आपको लिटरेचर कैसे पढ़ाऊंगा क्लास में जब आपकी इंग्लिश की वीक होगी? लिटरेचर तो बाद में आएगा ना, सबसे पहले क्या आएगा? लैंग्वेज है, राइट? फिफ्थ, इट हैपेंड व्हाइल आई स्टेड इन आयरलैंड, राइट? लुक एट द आंसर। व्हाइल के बाद हमेशा आईएनजी आएगा क्योंकि वाइल दो चीजें साइमल्टेनियसली दिखाता है। अब वापिस से पढ़िए, वाइल आई वाज स्टेइंग, वापिस पढ़िए, It happened while I was staying in Ireland. While I was staying, during that time, it happened. Right? Like this, one by one, ye bataye, seventh bataye. Who has given you that? ठीक है अब देखिए आंसर सेवंथ पे नजर रखिएगा Who gave you that? Who has given you that? Cannot be spoken. Why not? आपको क्या पता किसने कितनी देर पहले दिया क्या आपको पता है कि आप वहां खड़े थे तो आप कैसे प्रेजेंट परफेक्ट यूज कर सकते हैं किसी ने एक घंटे पहले ही दिया हो आधे घंटे पहले ही दिया हो वो आदमी चला गया तभी पूछ रहे हो ना कि किसने दिया जो वो आदमी वहां है ही नहीं तो उसका इन्फ्लुएंस तो प्रेजेंट मोमेंट पे होगा ही नहीं तो आपको हमेशा बोलना पड़ेगा हु गिव यू दैट मेरी बात समझ में आई है अगेन प्रेजेंट परफेक्ट और पास्ट सिंपल का रूल हम आपको ग्रामर का रूल पढ़ाएंगे फर्स्ट मेक मिस्टेक फर्स्ट फॉल डाउन फर्स्ट फील द पेन देन वी विल स्ट्रेच आवर हैंड्स एंड होप यू टू स्ट्रेच आउट And then when you will stand up, you will never fall down. You are ready to be Milka Singh. Right? These are few. I made a lot of slides. You can do it on your own. Let's talk about this. 11th one. Use my phone? Yes, of course you could. Right? Look at the answer. You cannot use when you are using use my phone here you cannot use the word could yes you can because it's not has gone in past yet abhi aapne pucha use my phone yes you can yes you could that means the moment is over development point so very simple exercises like this but this is applied linguistics तो आप जो ग्रामर पढ़ते हैं ना इफ यू नीड आई एम सेइंग इट ओपनली दिस सेमेस्टर नाउ वी आर कमिंग डाउन एंडिंग ऑफ सेमेस्टर लेट इट गो व्हेन नेक्स्ट सेमेस्टर स्टार्ट्स राइट लेट अस स्टार्ट फ्रॉम सिंपल ग्रामर एक्सरसाइज प्रेजेंट टेंस मैं सब वापस पढ़ाएंगे आप बट देन आई नीड आई डोंट वॉन्ट कि आप 100 या 80 आए आप 20 स्टूडेंट्स आइए मैं रेगुलर पढ़ाऊंगा बट आई नीड दोज स्टूडेंट्स हू आर कमिटेड एंड दे वॉन्ट रियली टू इम्प्रूव समथिंग You got my point what I'm saying. Right? Sorry, I had to skip at a lot of slides. It always happens. We, when teachers want to teach you something, we think of teaching you everything. Ends up teaching only selective things. Right? So, other slides, I will again leave this PPT. Please read it, go through this. Maybe some of these slides and this teach from me as a teacher who was a BAMA student and did PhD. एक चीज होती है कि हो सकता है ऐसे ही कोई कॉन्फ्रेंस टॉक में आपको कोई टॉपिक मिल जाए आपके रिसर्च पेपर के लिए आपकी एमफिल के लिए या आपकी बीएससी यू नेवर नो दिस इज हाउ वी ग्रो ध्यान से पढ़िए यू वांट टू डिस्कस समथिंग विद अस वी आर अराउंड राइट एंड देन और इफ नॉट लेट्स स्टार्ट कंटिन्यूअसली अ ट्रेडिशन इन दिस यूनिवर्सिटी वी आर रेडी टू हेल्प यू आउट नेक्स्ट सेमेस्टर Every week, one lecture on behalf of English department on the topics which you wish to. And if you want, sir, हमें नहीं पता है, हमें बस improve करना है, then leave it on us. Right? ये जो हुआ ना workshop of linguistics, ये तब आएगा जब आप यहाँ हैं. Right? So when he came and he said, I said, okay, absolutely. Because he said कि sir, आचार्य के students के लिए. Then I said, let everybody be part of that. So at least now you know the concepts. That's interesting. But abhi hume bahut mehnat peeche se karni padegi. Right? So we are ready to go to A, start from scratch. If you are willing to do that, let's continue this relationship after classes. This negotiation where we are capable to come up with something concrete. Fair enough?